It's time for Dodger Baseball. Live from Dodger Stadium, Sportsnet LA presents the Dodgers as they take on the Colorado Rockies. Hi, everybody, and a very pleasant Tuesday evening to you, wherever you may be. Game two of the series, Rockies won last night, Dodgers trying to come back tonight. The Dodgers had a six-game winning streak at home snapped last night, but they've still won 10 of the last 13. They trail the Giants by four, and the Rockies trail by eight. The Giants are home, playing a brief two-game series with the Boston Red Sox. On the mound for tonight will be the 19-year-old left-hander Julio Urias. His mom and dad will make the trip from Culiacan, Mexico. They'll be in the stands watching him work tonight. Naturally, when you talk about Urias, it's natural to think about Fernando Valenzuela. Well, there's one difference already. Urias is 223 days younger than Fernando. And Fernando had 10 relief assignments under his belt before he made his first start here at Dodger Stadium. And that was a beauty, a complete game shutout. As far as the Dodgers are concerned, after Urias, they will then have Chris Russell as the opponent. They'll have Kenta Maeda on the mound. On the mound for the Rockies would be Eddie Butler. 2 years ago, made his debut against the Dodgers. They beat him. He's 0-4 lifetime. But sit back, relax. We have a good ball game coming up and a whole lot more right after this. Tuesday evening to you. Welcome to Dodger Stadium. There's a lot of Mexican music in the background, and that's the theme song for tonight, as young 19-year-old Julio Urias has reached the mound, making his third major league start. And of course, this one has an extra special home touch to it. His family, his mom and dad, his father, Carlos Alberto Urias. He's a baseball coach now. His mom, Juani Isabel Acosta, she works in a daycare center. His brother, Carlos Alberto Urias, who is 13 years old, plays baseball. And finally, his young sister, Alexia Guadalupe Urias, she is all of 5 years old. Well, he has his own cheering section. Little interesting note, too, he is wearing number 7. The last time a Dodger pitcher wore a single number, you have to go back to 1943. The Dodgers had a very much of a character by the name of Bobo Newsom, who wore number 8 and went 9-4 for the Dodgers in 1943. There have been a lot of people who wore 7, including a Dodger manager, a famous man in his own right, Charlie Dressen. So here we go, as Urias, you can hear the Mexican music in the background, mariachi band playing. Meanwhile, DJ LeMahieu will check in and be followed by Ryan Rayburn and then Nolan Arenado. Sitting upstairs and you're wondering his own thoughts, Fernando Valenzuela, after 10 relief appearances in 1980, he broke in here as a starter and pitched a complete game shutout in 1981. So now the crowd comes alive as LeMahieu checks in. DJ, 1-for-3 last night, right hand hitting second baseman, and a good one. Urias into his windup, left-handed, deals fastball high, ball one. Great interest always, but when you look at the two benches, they're both eager to watch, both the Dodgers, who have seen him before, and the Rockies, who have never watched him. Urias comes right back, 1-0, fastball in for a strike, and the crowd reacts. 67 degrees. It is a gorgeous time of day on this 7th of June. Urias' feet together on the rubber, peeking over the fingertips of his glove. Now the 1-1 pitch on the way, off speed, fouled away, and the count 1-2. Urias wears glasses, and he'll be facing LeMahieu, Rayburn, and Arenado, and then hitting cleanup will be the left-hand hitting Carlos Gonzalez. So Julio Cesar Acosta Urias, ready? The 1-2 pitch on the way, fastball at 93 high, and the count 2-2. There are many people deeply interested in tonight's performance. You can imagine most of them. The left-hander at attention, now ready in the 2-2 pitch on the way, swung on, hit in the air to left center, on the run and picking it off easily in center field is Jock Peterson, and we have one away. We have a minute now. Let's take a look at the lineup furnished for Colorado and the Dodgers defensively. Gonzalez and Utley, Seager and Turner. The outfield of Kendrick, Peterson and Thompson, and Grandal handling Urias. So Ryan Rayburn, who did not play in last night's game, he had a tough series in San Diego, went 0-for-5. Veteran who's been around a while takes a strike and the count 0-1. Rayburn went 0-5 while they were in San Diego. Ryan Neal Rayburn and takes a strike. He's born in Tampa, Florida, lives in Plant City, originally a fifth round pick by the Detroit Tigers. He's 35 years old. So you have a 35-year-old facing a 19-year-old, and the strike 2 pitch, fastball high at 93. Julio Cesar Acosta, which is his mother's name, and then Urias, his father's name. The 1-2 pitch, fastball whacked down the left field line in the corner. That thing was blistered. Rayburn on his way to an easy jogging double into second base. So LeMahieu flied to left center. Rayburn jumps on a pitch and drills it. Fastball knee high out over the plate. So that's a dangerous pitch in almost any league. and in the major leagues it spells trouble. So Rayburn doubles, and now the top hitter, the number one player right now, the young Nolan Arenado. Arenado hitting 295, remarkable player, 18 home runs, 48 runs batted in, leading the majors, and also a magical glove. And right behind him is Carlos Gonzalez. So Urias will really be tested now with these two hitters. Urias set, looks back at second base, comes to the plate, breaking ball low, one ball and no strikes. Arenado can do it all. Last night, 2-for-4, scored a run, had an RBI, and as usual, he's an all-star third baseman. One ball and no strikes. Arenado waits. The 1-0 pitch, fastball, swung on and missed. That's as hard as Urias has thrown tonight. That was a 95-mile-an-hour fastball. Nolan back up. Julio checking. Yasmani Grandal shuffling cards behind the plate. Urias out of a stretch. And Julio's 1-1 pitch on the way to Arenado, and that's taken low. Took a little bit off, and the count 2-1. When Urias was finally called up by the Dodgers, that was May the 27th this year. He called his father, and as his father said later on, I dropped to my knees and cried. He was overcome by the fact young Julio was called to the bigs. 2-1 pitch on the way. Fastball missing down and away. When the family heard that he was going up to the big leagues, the very first thing they did, the entire family, they went to church and gave thanks. All right, 3-1 the count to Nolan Arenado. Carlos Gonzalez waiting on deck. Urias staring in. And the 3-1 pitch to Nolan, the right-hand batter. Urias delivers. Oh, breaking ball in for a strike. So he threw breaking ball 3-1. Of course, you had better in the big leagues. If you're looking behind with only fastballs, you will not be around very long. So Urias, highly talented. He has fastball, curve, and change. No trick pitch. Yasmani will set a target for him in a moment. And a 3-2 pitch to Nolan Arenado. Urias, a high set. Here he comes. Breaking ball down and in for ball four. So the crowd groaning or cheering. They are emotionally involved with young Urias. Maybe a lot of people from Culiacan in Mexico. Of course, Fernando from Echeverría. They're about 260 miles apart. So now Carlos Gonzalez. If one thing Carlos Gonzalez knows, he understands how Corey Seager felt when Corey hit three home runs the other night. Because Carlos has hit three home runs in a game twice. 4 years ago against Houston, 3 years ago against Cincinnati. He spells trouble, and he's in healthy condition. First pitch to Carlos, swung on and missed, 0-1. Gonzalez hitting 304, 13 home runs, 29 runs batted in. He had knee problems for a couple of years. Now he's feeling well, and it's reflected on his game, and he's up there with two on, one out, no score, first inning. The strike one pitch, Julio deals, swung on and missed, good fastball up and on the outside part of the plate. So he jumps out in front of a very good hitter, Carlos Gonzalez. Young man at 19 has made 17 pitches. Rayburn away from second, Arenado from first, and the strike two pitch to Carlos Gonzalez. Left hand already, Gonzalez open stance, takes up around the eyes, 1-2 the count. Of course, Carlos might have that open stance, but that right leg, which is closer to first base, suddenly swings back to get him right on target. So he's opened up for the moment. Urias looks down, gets a sign. Carlos wigwagging the bat back and forth. Now Arias kind of in a crouch on the mound, straightens up, left-handed delivers, breaking ball, a high and away. Arias is 6 feet one and 205 pounds. He will be a birthday August the 12th. So two balls and two strikes, two on, one out, first inning, no score. Arias delivers, fastball, got him swinging at 94. And the first thing Carlos did was ask the umpire, was it a strike? And I believe Jim Joyce said no. It was a fastball up and probably outside the plate, very close. So the family breathing hard every moment here, two on, two out. And now another story by the name of Trevor. And he is quite a story. Hit a big three-run home run last night. He has 16 home runs, 42 runs batted in. He's Colorado's answer to Corey Seager. Arias, left foot on the rubber, looks in to get a sign. Might feel a little more at home here. They tell me he was a bit frightened in New York and then again in Chicago, and a good curveball, slow breaking ball for a strike. 0-1. So he's not going to just spend the night trying to throw fastballs. That was a very, very good off-speed breaking ball. So Trevor waiting. No balls in one strike. Two on, two out. First inning, no score. Arias, a high set up around the letters. Back with a fastball down and away. Actually took a lot off that. He's made 22 pitches, so he is laboring a little bit. Arias staring in. Two previous starts. Now the left-hander ready, checks the runners. 1-1 pitch, another curveball, a flare foul, broken bat as well. You could hear it like a celery stalk up here. So time for the moment as Story has to go back and get another one. Big breaking ball got in on the hands and the bat cracked. Story, the only Rockies player other than the great Todd Helton to homer in his first two major league games. And then he became the fifth player in major league history to homer in four straight games to start a season. And he hit his eighth home run in his first 13 major league games. So no player in the modern era has ever done that. So it's a big battle. 1-2 to count. Story in and then backs out. Trevor from Irving, Texas. Urias from Calican in Mexico. Crowd trying to root him over. Here's the 1-2 pitch. Fastball got him swinging up around the eyes. So Julio strikes out two, gives up a double and a single, and fights his way out of it. That's a pretty good inning to strike out Gonzalez and Story back to back. The end of half an inning. Joy here and no score. And it'll be Chase Utley to lead it off, followed by Corey Seager, and then Justin Turner hitting third. Adrian Gonzalez hits cleanup. Trace Thompson, Jock Peterson, Howie Kendrick, Yasmani Grandal, and Julio Urias. Right now, Chase Utley rested, sat out last night, climbs into the box, takes the first pitch high. Ball one, 1-0. His name is Eddie Butler. He's from Chesapeake, Virginia. 6'2", 180, 25 years old, a first-round pick by the Rockies. The 1-0 pitch on the way. Eddie's fastball off the plate, so he's behind Utley, 2-0. Chase hitting 268, done a good job leading off, scoring 32 runs. He has four home runs, 20 runs batted in. Here comes Butler back with a fastball again outside, and the count 3-0. Eddie's had a nightmare time against the Dodgers. A couple of years ago, 2 years in early June, almost an anniversary, he made his big league debut and the Dodgers racked him up. Fastball in for a strike. Dodgers scored 7 runs against Eddie that day, and they're beating him 4 times without Eddie coming up with a victory. The 3-1 pitch coming up, pitching almost out of a stretch, another fastball inside corner, and the count 3-2. Jim Joyce, a veteran umpire behind the plate, with Adam Hamari, James Hoy, Chad Fairchild working the lines. Joyce, 29 years as an umpire in the big league, so he knows what's going on. 3-2 is low, ball 4, and Utley goes to first.
Shortstop, number 5.
So Eddie Butler walking the leadoff man, and now here's Corey Seager. And one of the more intriguing stories that will hold up throughout the year, whenever Colorado plays, how did Seager do? How did Story do? Well, Trevor Story struck out in the first inning, so we'll see what Corey does now, checking in against Butler. Corey waiting, Utley at first, short lead. Butler ready and delivers, and he is inside, ball 1-0. So Seager with his fan club certainly filling out membership cards, and well worth the visit. Butler accepted a baseball scholarship to Radford University, that's in Virginia. He comes back with an off-speed pitch, drops it in nicely for a strike. As a first-round pick, he got first-round money. He has 2 fastballs, the four-seamer and the 2, slider, curve, and change. They say his fastball is rated a 70 on the scale to 80. The pitch is off the plate, but it's the old story, no matter how hard you throw, if you're not throwing strikes and if it's not moving, you're in trouble. 2 balls and 1 strike to count. Utley short lead at first. Butler looks over there, he's not going. Seager tries to time a pitch, doesn't get it. 2-2 the count to Corey. For Butler, of course, he has to shake a memory as Justin Turner waits on deck. The last game that he pitched was a nightmare. He allowed 8 runs against Cincinnati. 2-2 pitch coming up. Utley's not going. Fastball inside, ball 3. In looking at the important stats for Butler, to give you some idea, his numbers look good. He has only walked 6 and struck out 24. So that 4-1 ratio is very good. But he starts off with a walk and then 3-2 to the next hitter. So Utley taking his lead. We'll see what he does. He is going. The pitch is taken for ball 4. So Eddie Butler in trouble immediately, back to back walk. It's a nightmare for a young player. And now the catcher, Dustin Garneau, goes out to try and console him, say, hey, don't get down, we're just starting the game. But coming off that nightmare 8-run game in Cincinnati, it's pretty hard for him not to say, oh my gosh, here I go again. Well, he better change his mind, because Turner, Gonzalez, and Thompson coming up. 2 on, nobody out. Turner has posted, believe it or not, a 727 batting average against Eddie Butler. That translates into 8 for 11 with 3 doubles. Turner at the belt waiting for him, and the first pitch to Justin is low, ball one. 1-0. For Stephen Foster, the pitching coach, and for the manager, Walt Weiss. Kind of a nightmare inning for a young pitcher. You can bet they're really rooting for him in the Colorado dugout. Now the 1-0 pitch on the way. Butler fires, and he's low again. 2 balls and no strikes. Tom Reynolds with his elbows on the railing, looking out, trying to help just by looking. Butler staring in. Walked Utley, walked Seager. Now 2-0 to Justin Turner, who has beaten him up in the past. 2-0 pitch on the way. Fastball whacked into left center field. It is gone, and it's 3-0 Dodgers. So it is another nightmare against the Dodgers for Eddie Butler. For Justin Turner, a big home run. The last one was in San Diego on the 22nd of May. And I mean, he jumped all over Butler. Butler, by the way, has allowed 7 home runs, and the Dodgers lead 3-0. And of course, the crowd is ecstatic because that gives Urias a pretty good cushion to lean on. The pitch now to Adrian Gonzalez, a strike. The Butler got a fastball on the inside part of the plate and just turned on it. There was no doubt about it. So does he ever own Butler? There's a drive to left coming up in a hurry to play it on a bounce of Rayburn. So for Eddie Butler, the thought of the Dodgers must be a nightmare. And for Walt Weiss, not much he can do as his young pitcher is being exploited by the Dodgers again. Turner with 4 home runs, and kind of a shock to realize first one he's hit at home. So for Butler, his earned run average against the Dodgers coming into the game was 7, and he's given up 3 in the first inning. Here's Trace Thompson. Gonzalez at first, nobody out. Trace has a look at ball one. Thompson playing right field tonight. He just looks so much more comfortable playing right than he does in center. The 1-0 pitch on the way, fastball low. So for Butler now, he's at that very bad stage for a young pitcher. It's like the world is against him. He walked Utley and Seager, gave up the home run to a guy who was beating him over the head anyway, Justin Turner. Turner against him is now 9 for 12 with 3 doubles and a home run. So in this instance, the Butler can't do it. And the 2-0 pitch is way off the plate, ball 3. Meanwhile, young Julio sitting back enjoying a 3-0 lead. And we're in the first inning. All right, Thompson back up, 3-0. Gonzalez at first. Butler at the belt. 3-0 pitch on the way is outside. Well, no one has gone to the mound to console or help. Though in a moment you would think somebody will do something. And here he comes, Stephen Foster, the pitching coach. What a first inning. A walk to Utley, a walk to Seager, and a 3-run home run to Turner. And then a single to Gonzalez and a walk to Thompson. What a difference, considering last night the Dodgers managed 1 hit, a ground ball single into right field. So Turner has certainly done the damage, and he can leave the dugout for a little while. Boy, that is really owning a pitcher. 9 for 12. 3 doubles and a home run and 5 runs batted in. Jorge De La Rosa will now get up. Left-hander in the bullpen. Jock Peterson checking in with Kendrick on deck. Three runs, two hits for the Dodgers. Rockies had a double and a walk in their first inning. The 3-0 Dodgers. Butler set, checks the runners. Here he comes. Fastball in for a strike. And the count 0-1. They talk about his fastball being a 70 on a scale 20 to 80. He also has, they say, a good sinker. We haven't seen it. The off-speed pitch is fouled away. So that was his slow curve or changeup. They say his changeup can be as much as 87. That's not a bad changeup when you can throw 99 with the fastball. But he's paid the price. He's been behind, and now he's behind on the scoreboard. Nobody out. No balls and two strikes, they count to Jock Peterson. Jock waiting, 8 home runs, 26 runs batted in. And the strike two pitch instead, Butler wants to talk to his catcher. Eddie Butler, a young first round pick. They were very high on him when they signed him. 25 years old in March. Been pitching professionally only since 2012. And he actually broke in 14 and got roughed up. Though at second base, you have Gonzalez at first, Thompson. Nobody out. Strike two pitch on the way to Jock. Swung on, a towering fly ball. It is gonna go foul and down the right field line. Though still 0-2. It was fouled by a lot and it was short by a lot. But it was a mile high by a lot. Boy, what a beautiful evening. Powder blue sky, traces of light clouds overhead. And Eddie Butler ready and deals and misses inside, ball one. 1-2. He's also labored. He's made 25 pitches. This is the kind of an inning, really, a rookie pitcher would pitch in Colorado. Here's the 1-2 pitch coming up to Peterson. Swung on, big bouncer, backhanded by Arenado. He's on the bag for one. Safe, however, at first. Ball net hard enough for them to get two. So Peterson forces Gonzalez on a ground ball to third. Thompson at second. Peterson at first. Again, Garneau out to the mound to talk to his pitcher. Walt Weiss was on the steps in case they were going to argue. They didn't. After looking at the tape, but it was very close. The Walt Weiss, seeing a young pitcher having a bad time, it's down 3-0 as far as Colorado is concerned. And here comes Howie Kendrick. Kendrick, proud possessor of the only hit last night. That was a ground ball single into right field. 3-0 Dodgers first inning. Runners at first and second and one out. And the pitch to Howie swung on and missed. 0-1 the count. Kendrick, so valuable, playing well at so many different positions. Playing left field tonight. Strike one pitch on the way. Howie, right-hand hitter, takes a look, and that's a strike. And the count 0-2. Kendrick played second base last night, left field tonight. Butler with one out, hoping to see a light at the end of the tunnel. Kendrick is the seventh batter here in the first inning. Thompson taking his lead at second, Peterson at first. They're roommates, along with Corey Seager. Fastball is swept on, soft line drive to LeMay, who steps on the bag and they get the double play. Thompson could not get back. So, three runs on two hits. Justin Turner, the big man, He was hitting over 700 against Buckler when he checked in, and he hits the three-run home run. And at the end of an inning, 3-0, Dodgers. Turner did it. The Dodgers lead 3-0. Turner now is 9-4-12 against Eddie Buckler. Interesting, too, for the Dodgers coming up with three runs in the first inning. They have now outscored their opponents by 15 runs in the first inning, 35-20. Meanwhile, Julio Urias, a big breaking ball, a little high, one ball and no strikes to Mark Reynolds. Reynolds hitting .292. Three home runs, 17 runs batted in. A much traveled player takes a breaking ball strike. Urias, maybe it's the impatience of youth, but he sure doesn't hang around out there. He gets the ball and he's ready to pitch. The 1-1 pitch on the way. Julio delivers, just misses. Ball two, 2-1 the count. Mark Reynolds, been around a long time, you may remember. While in the National League, played with several teams, he hits one foul out of play. Reynolds was originally signed by the Arizona Diamondbacks, so that started off his big league career in 2007. And he went from the Diamondbacks to the Orioles, then to the Indians, then to the Yankees, then the Brewers, then the Cardinals, and back with the Rockies. The pitch to him high and inside. 3-2. Julio gave up a double to Rayburn and a walk to Arenado, but then struck out Gonzalez and Story. Left-hander comes back, 3-2, fastball grounded to first, backhanded nicely by Adrian, and takes it to the bag. So Gonzalez handles one just inside the bag and down the line. And Gerardo Parra coming up. Parra, a very talented outfielder, last night played left field, center field tonight. Last night had a home run, a single, and a stolen base. Hitting .268, five home runs, 26 runs batted in. Julio into the windup, first pitch, nice breaking ball for a strike, and the count 0-1. Boy, he's got that pitch down. Urias staring. Now he's ready. The 0-1 pitch hit off the end of the bat, foul, and the count 0-2. Gerardo Enrique Parra, born in Santa Barbara del Zulia. That's in Venezuela. Boy, any player who's from Venezuela, you have to really have sympathy for them. with all hell breaking loose in that country. Strike two pitch on the way. Breaking ball hit foul off to the left. Parrish 5'11", a good 200. 29 years old. Signed by the Diamondbacks 12 years ago as a free agent. Strike two pitch on the way. Big pitch over the head of Parra. That was not exactly a message pitch, I don't believe. Just got away. It was a good foot over Parra's head, and he's 5'11". So Julio, feet together, takes a moment, slows down after that. One ball and two strikes. Parra settling in. Urias ready in his 1-2 pitch. Fastball grounded Dotley. Chases up with it, plenty of time, and takes care of Parra. Two down in the second inning. And the batter now will be Dustin Garneau. The Garneau, the catcher, checking in. Hitting 216, local boy. He was born in Torrance. Dustin, a 19th round pick by the Rockies, and takes his right. Dustin went to school at Cal State Fullerton. As we mentioned, born in Torrance. He'll be 29 in August. Strike one pitch, off speed and away, and a one ball, one strike count. Arias certainly pitching more confidently with a three run lead. Two out, second inning. He's retired four in a row. Julio ready. Now the 1-1 pitch. Half swing. That'll be a strike, and the count 1-2. Check swing, but he came around. Was up around the letters. One ball and two strikes. Julio, feet together, almost like Hershiser, except a little offline. Now the 1-2 pitch on the way. Half fastball up around the eyes. 2-2 the count. I don't think he has thrown a fastball down. Those fastballs are all sailing up. Though they would be the four seamer, but he has a two seamer that sinks. The next pitch outside, ball three. The Dustin Garneau, in looking at his numbers in the past, he had 15 home runs at Albuquerque. Eddie Butler is on deck. They call him Drago. Here's the 3-2 pitch, and Drago swings and misses. That's the third strikeout for Julio, who jumps over the third base foul line, so that might be a little bit of a superstition. But a good fastball to overcome Garneau, and at the end of an inning and a half, 3-0, Dodgers. lead 3-0. Two young pitchers, Eddie Butler for the Colorado Rockies and Julio Urias pitching for the Dodgers. Urias is leading, and he's retired the last five in a row. Butler's first pitch to Grandal off the plate, ball one, 1-0. Grandal 1-for-3 in the past against Eddie Butler, takes a strike, one ball and one strike. Arenado all alone on the left side. They load up the right, Story, LeMahieu, and Reynolds. Butler working fast, hard ground ball, wedged through into right center field. Picked up by Gonzalez. With that shift on Story, LeMahieu, and Reynolds, he still found the gap between Story and LeMahieu. To Randall, a leadoff single, and here comes Urias. Leading 3-0, we'll see if they ask him to bunt. Don't really know anything about what he does with the bat. Ah, yeah, the family is up there and they are thrilled. So we'll see. Two sacrifice bunts and two plate appearances. Showing bunt. And gets it down sharply to Arenado. Down to second for one. Back to first, double play. I'll say one thing, he bunted it to the wrong man, Nolan Arenado, who pounced on that and got two. So the double play.
Chase Utley.
Arenado charging, picks it without breaking the motion, fires it down to Story and back to first. 5-6-3. Two out. That would be the second double play turned in by the Rockies. The other was the line drive that went to LeMahieu. So Arenado turns the bunt and kills two, and here's Utley. Chase walked and rode home on the three-run home run by Justin Turner. First pitch in for a strike, and the count 0-1. Urias has made 41 pitches in his two innings. Butler has made 34. The next pitch to Utley is low. One ball and one strike. Dodgers racking up three quickly in the first inning. Two walks and a home run by Justin Turner. 1-1 pitch on the way. Utley has a look and it's low. Ball two, 2-1. Up north, the Giants are playing the Red Sox. It's Rick Porcello and Albert Suarez. Porcello is 7-2. Suarez 1-1. Red Sox got a run and lead 1-0 second inning. Ground ball foul. The run came in the second inning. Chris Young doubled it in. So the outfield stacked on the right side. Butler from a stretch comes to the plate, swung on and missed. Though for him, that's a very pleasant second inning. Base hit, double play, strikeout. No runs, one hit, nobody left. And at the end of two, 3-0 Dodgers. Julio Urias on the mound at 19. Here's the youngest Dodger pitcher, Joe Mohler in 1962, 19 and 73 days. Dick Kalmus, 228. Urias, 300. And then going back to Edwin Jackson and Clayton Kershaw, they're old men at 20. And a fastball jumps in on Eddie Butler. One ball and no strikes. Urias comes right back, zeroes in with a strike, and a one ball, one strike. Butler, who wobbled all over the place in the first inning, made a very quick recovery in the second. So it's 3-0 Dodgers, top of the third. Change curve, and that drops low. 2-1 the count. We haven't seen a straight change. We've seen him take a lot off his curveball, and his fastball's in the mid-90s. Urias ready. 2-1 pitch on the way. Fastball at 93. Swung on and missed. And the count 2-2. Butler with the bat has not done anything. He's had 9 at bats. He's only struck out once. 2-2 pitch on the way. Fastball hit late and foul outside of first by old friend Eric Young. EY coaching at first. Stu Cole at third. Eric Young with the Dodgers 1997, 98, 99. 2-2 pitch on the way. Breaking ball, slow roller. Turner cuts in front of Seager and throws him out. So very quietly now, Urias has retired six in a row. With one out, he gave up a double to Rayburn and he walked Arenado. And then he turned right around. Struck out Gonzalez, struck out Story, and retired the side in order in the second, and the leadoff man in the third. DJ LeMahieu flied to pretty deep left center in his at bat. Urias fastball late fouled away. That was at 94. 0-1 the count. The DJ is David John, but he prefers the initials. The strike one pitch off speed in there for a strike. Last year, LeMahieu struggled, hit about 136 against left-handers and 377 against right-handers. Here's the strike two pitch, time for the moment. Jim Joyce walking away from home plate. No balls and two strikes. And that's high, 1-2. LeMahieu stands 6'4". So he has joined a fellow they called High Pockets. That was George Kelly way back in 1925 of the Giants as the tallest everyday second baseman in Major League history. 1-2 pitch, crack bat, foul ball. I think it was cracked. It sounded like it, but apparently not. So LeMahieu's still there. DJ backs out, checks back in. He had 12 assists in a game a couple of years ago at second base. Takes very high, 2-2. And that tied a major league record for assists by a second baseman. He was the 10th man to do it. He's a gold glover. He had a gold glove 2 years ago. 2-2 pitch, DJ swings and grounds it foul. So he's up there hacking away. He was born in Visalia, lives in Michigan, and originally a second round pick by the Cubs, went to school at LSU. His dad's the guy who taught him how to play baseball the right way. 2-2 pitch. LeMahieu fouls it the other way upstairs. Fifty-four pitches, though he's made 13 so far here in the third inning. Made 24 pitches in the first inning, did Urias. 2-2 to DJ LeMahieu. Fastball hit to the hole by the diving Turner into left field. So LeMahieu was right on Urias, kept fouling him off, and then grounds a single into left field. Say, don't forget, the first 40,000 fans in attendance Father's Day, June 19th, will receive Dodger Boxers, compliments of Chef Marito seasonings. After the game, play catch on the field. So for tickets, visit Dodgers.com/promotion. Rockies have two hits, a double by Rayburn, who's checking in right now, and the single by LeMahieu. Rayburn, right-hand batter. First pitch to him, in for a strike, and the count 0-1. Played under Jim Leland in Detroit. Played for years with the Tigers, then a couple of years with the Indians, and now with the Rockies. LeMahieu at first, it's 3-0 Dodgers. Top of the third, throw to first, and LeMahieu back. LeMahieu has 5 stolen bases. Gerardo Parra has 6. 0-1 the count to Ryan Neal Rayburn. Right-hand batter at 6 feet, 185, takes in the dirt, and the count 1-1. Rayburn went to school at South Florida Community College. He was a 5th-round pick by Detroit. He was drafted by the Devil Rays, but he decided to go from community college to the University of Florida. 1-1. Urias set and straightens up. 1-1 pitch, fastball foul back at 94. So 1-2 the count to Ryan Redburn. His brother John played for a few years in the minor leagues. For Ryan, his dad is a pastor, survived lung cancer, and his brother had a broken back in high school, but he's in the Tampa Bay Devil Rays system. 1-2, there goes the runner, the off-speed pitch, a high throw, great effort by Utley. Number one, somehow he caught it, and number two, he came close as he was coming down, a big sweeping tag, and LeMahieu was just under it. Breaking ball, it stayed up, then the ball sailed. Utley climbs the ladder but couldn't get his man. So LeMahieu steals second. One out, 2-2 the count to Rayburn. Urias looking back. Now the 2-2 pitch, fastball got him swinging. 4 strikeouts for Julio Urias, and the batter will be Nolan Arenado. Just went right back to the heater and picks up number 4. So 2 down, LeMahieu at second base. Dodgers over shift with Arenado, and that serves 2 purposes. Utley fills up the middle, and he's also directly behind second base to cut down LeMahieu's lead. Red Sox lead the Giants 2-1 in the 3rd inning. Jarrett Parker hit a home run for the Giants. 3-0 Dodgers, 3rd inning, 2 out. Rockies have a runner at second. Pitch to Arenado, off speed and high. Ball 1. 1-0. Arenado, by the time he is through, will certainly have his name linked with Mike Schmidt. We talked about that last night. 1-0 pitch on the way, taken off the plate. Arenado last year led the National League in home runs and RBIs. He was tied with Bryce Harper for home runs. And this year he's leading in home runs and RBIs. And the last fellow to do it, Mike Schmidt. 2-0 pitch on the way, change in there, 2-1. I'll never forget walking into, I guess in those days it was Shive Park, maybe Veterans Stadium. And I saw a left-hand hitter in the cage hitting balls out of sight. And I thought, wow, Phillies have a new hitter, and what a hitter. And I mean, he was tearing the ball up. 2-1 pitch instead, just to look back at third. And when I got down on the field, I was asking, who is that left-hand hitter hitting the balls over the pavilion? They said, that's Mike Schmidt. I said, Mike Schmidt, he's a right hand batter. Yeah, but he used to switch in college. I asked him why he wouldn't hit left handed. Mike said, I'd never been in the big leagues. Fastball hit in the air to left field. Going back on the ball is Kendrick at the wall. It's off the wall. Peterson late coming over there. And one run is in on a booming double by Nolan Arenado. Oh, he's at it again. Arenado now has 49 runs batted in, 18 home runs. So it's 3-1. Ball just missed going out. Kendrick went back, and when the ball came off, it was a while before Jock Peterson could get over there. Kendrick didn't have a chance to get it. Double off the wall, scoring LeMahieu, whose stolen base is cashed in. And now, if one trouble is in Arenado, another is Carlos Gonzalez. Three runs, three hits for the Dodgers. One run, three hits for the Rockies. Gonzalez struck out in the first inning. Fastball is in for a strike, and the count 0-1. Cargo, as they call him, terrific player, and as we mentioned, his knees kind of gave way, which will happen when you played as long as he has. Strike one pitch, waved at and missed. Big curveball, and he was a long way from the ball. 0-2. Cargo is 31 years old come October. No balls, two strikes. Urias with two out, trying to put him away. Looks back at second, works the hitter, fastball foul back. The last 2 years, Carlos Gonzalez, plagued by injuries, played about 180 games in the last two. He wears out Madison Bumgarner and doesn't hit Kershaw. That's kind of interesting. Strike two pitch coming up. Urias delivers off the plate, foul back. That was off the plate and down, and Gonzalez went after it and was fortunate to foul it away. Cargo, well, in his very first year, he won the batting title. He had 336, the highlight of which was in July. He had a walk-off home run to cap off the cycle. No balls and two strikes. Urias crouches, then straightens up. And the strike two pitch swung on and missed. He strikes Cargo out again. Five strikeouts for Julio. However, that man Arenado doubled off the wall to drive in a run. And at the end of 2.5 innings, 3-1 Dodgers. favor of the Dodgers. Bottom of the third inning. Seager, Turner, and Gonzalez. Right-hander Eddie Butler delivers. Ground ball up the middle. DeLeju up with it on his knees, but he can't get a hold of it. And it'll be an infield single for Corey Seager. So DeLeju got over there, and that was all he could do is drop to his knees. And here comes the nightmare for Eddie Butler by the name of Justin Turner. Turner came up in the first inning following two walks and crushed one. A three-run home run, fourth of the year. Interestingly enough, the first home run he's hit at Dodger Stadium this year. Justin wears out Butler. We'll see if Butler even tries to pitch to him with a runner at first. Right-handed delivers. Off speed, down and away, ball one, 1-0. Turner again is 9-for-12. He has three doubles and a home run. Five runs batted in against Butler. The 1-0 pitch on the way. Butler delivers, fastball hit foul into the crowd behind the visiting dugout. One ball and one strike. 41 pitches made so far by Eddie Butler. And by the way, although Urias is leading, he has now made 69 pitches in his three innings. There's no way he's going to be around very long doing that. The 1-1 pitch on the way. Butler fakes a throw to first. Three to one. Dodgers lead, bottom of the third. The 1-1 pitch coming up. Butler's fastball in the dirt. 2-1 the count. So Turner feeling a lot happier about things. It's been tough for him trying to figure out what's wrong. Came into the game hitting only 223. And as we mentioned last night, one of his problems, hitting nice fly balls to right field. Sure enough, last night he hit three fly balls to right, but tonight he hit one to left. Ground ball to the right side. LeMahieu going back to his shortstop. Story has no other play. Nice slide, breaking it up. Corey Seager sliding in.
Number 23.
So it's the force play. 4-6. That breeze you hear was Eddie Butler sighing in relief. Finally found a way to get Turner. So one out. Adrian Gonzalez single to left in the first inning. Dodgers got three when Turner followed two walks with a home run. The Rockies came back a single by LeMahieu, who stole second. And with one out, Arenado doubled high off the left field wall to score LeMahieu. Butler at the belt, ready and deals inside, moving Gonzalez off the plate, ball one. They load up the right side, and Arenado gives him all of third, most of short. Arenado, the third baseman, way over to his left. The 1-0 pitch on the way. Gonzalez tries to poke it, came up empty, 1-1. That was a pitch that had he made contact, I think he might have hit that ball to left field. So Butler, who went through that nightmare first inning trying to settle down. Eddie is ready in the 1-1 pitch on the way inside. Backhanded nicely by the catcher Dustin Garneau. Dodgers doing what they've done so well this year, jumping on the opponent in the first inning. 3 tonight and 35 so far this year. Turner hit into a force play. Takes his lead at first. 2-1 pitch on the way. Swung on, pulled to the middle man. That's LeMahieu. It goes to Arenado, who throws to first in time for the out. So Arenado, the third baseman, was playing short. And that's the second double play turned in by the Rockies. No runs a hit, nobody left. And at the end of three, 3-1. Dodgers. is brought to you by the Dodge Challenger. Test drive one at your local Dodge dealer today. And by Jack in the Box. It's back. The Portobello Mushroom Buttery Jack. Taste it before it's gone at Jack in the Box. Well, in the old days, you could try to break up a double play. That's Jim Gilliam off the bag. And that's flying Phil Rizzuto, the scooter of the Yankees, making the play to first. Two great names in baseball in the past. Ground foul. 0-1 the count to Trevor Story. Story's dad, a fireman. He said if he wasn't a ball player, he'd have followed his dad. He was a football player, quarterback, broke his collarbone, and that's when he decided to go to baseball. Interesting, before opening day, Story was called into Walt Weiss's office, and Walt said to him, "Do you have any video on Granky?" And Story said, "Well, I've watched him a lot." And Weiss said, "Well, you're going to be facing him here in a couple of days." Two balls, one strike. Good change, but low. So Trevor made his very first appearance, a three-run opposite field home run against Zach Greinke in the third inning at Chase Field. That's how he broke in. 3-1 pitch, fouled away. In his next at bat, I mean, here you are floating in the air, having just hit a three-run home. He came up against Greinke again and proceeded to take him deep for another home run. Two home runs against a great pitcher opening day. The first Rocky player to do that since Jeff Baker. This time he strikes out a second time, however, against Julio. Julio Urias, out of nowhere, Culiacan, Mexico. And the man who found him, Mike Brito. And of course, Mike forever a claim to fame. The fact that he found, signed, and brought Fernando Valenzuela to the Dodgers. So Brito now is hoping, because this will be his youngest man. He said tonight, Brito did, that Urias is my last. Well, he signed Julio when he was 16 years old. Brito is quite a character. In the old days, you would see him with a Panama hat. He'd be behind home plate with a velocity gun and a Louisville Slugger cigar. It wasn't quite as big as the bat that's being used by Mark Reynolds. Breaking ball strike. Six strikeouts for Urias. We're watching his pitch count, though. He's made 78. In his two games in the big leagues, against the Cubs, he made 79 pitches. And against the Mets, he made 81 pitches. And now you can bet the Dodgers are very close to getting him out of there. So he strikes out seven. So he struck out Gonzalez and Story back to back. Then he got Garneau. Then he nailed Rayburn. And then he got Gonzalez to end the third. Story and Reynolds in the fourth. I'm sure the Dodgers would love him to go five and thereby get him a win, but Lewis Coleman is throwing in the bullpen. That's a strike. I mean, he is zeroed in on the hitters. But again, most pitches 81, and he's ready to make number 81 right now. A bunt fouled away. In looking at his minor league work, the most pitches he made in a game, 82. So the crowd would like him to ring up another hitter, strike out the side, give him eight. Oh, and two. Wow, look where Grandal is, and he hit him. 1-2. Grandal on his way to San Diego, and Urias went right with the call. One ball, two strikes. Fouled away. No, 83 pitches. It'll be too bad. I mean, the crowd will groan, but I would not be surprised if he gets to the dugout. Dave will lift him. One ball and two strikes. Fouled away. So 84 pitches, more than he pitched in his other two big league starts, and the most pitches that he has made this year in any game, anywhere. One ball, two strikes. High foul, out of play. Well, he's still throwing 93. He's 6'1", 205 pounds. He'll be 20 August 12th. He is 223 days younger than Fernando. Curveball, soft line drive to Seager. Well, he has gone four. What's more important, however, is the pitch count. His family is thrilled. And he walks off. So the question now, will they send him back out there? It's 3-1, Dodgers. Through his four innings, Dave Roberts came in and talked to him. Rick Honeycutt shook his hand. It would appear they are not going to let him go back out there after 86 pitches. He's got a tremendous future ahead of him. He has not thrown more than 81 pitches until tonight. So despite the fact he's not wearing a windbreaker, I believe he's done for the evening. Lewis Coleman was throwing back of him. One of the things that plagued young Urias was the fact that the Rockies fouled off 19 pitches. That's maddening to a veteran, never mind to a kid. But there's no one throwing in the pen right now, so we'll wait and see. But from watching everybody go over, shaking his hands, they were saying, buenas noches, adios. Little squirt job fielded by Butler and takes care of Thompson. One away. Dodgers now will get somebody up again in the bullpen. So it's just about a cinch that Urias, with Lewis Coleman throwing for the second time. What a night he had. The only problem was he had 24 pitches in the first inning, 28 pitches in the third. Well, he wound up an 86. That's a cutoff number, isn't it? Jock Peterson hit into a force play in the first inning, 0 for 1. Good fastball. Boy, I tell you one thing, Eddie Butler has now settled in. Eddie was all over the lot in the first inning, gave up three, and he has come roaring back. No balls, one strike. And another strike. So Butler, who has just been pushed around by the Dodgers, no wins, four losses, had an earned run average over seven and gave up three in the first inning, now pitching like a far more confident young right-hander. Time. Jim Joyce does everything without a doubt. If there's time, he will walk 20, 30 feet away from home plate. When he calls a strike, he will turn and shoot that right hand out towards the Dodger dugout. One and two. Jim has been a tremendous asset. 29 years in the big leagues. Umpired in three World Series. He was the second base umpire when Nolan Ryan recorded his 5,000th career strikeout. And he was at first base when Robin Yount reached the 3,000 hit milestone. He lives in Orion. He has a BS in education from Bowling Green. Jim Joyce. 3-2. Good sinker. Down goes Peterson. And again, Butler looks like a totally different pitcher.
Number 47, Howie Kendrick.
That's his second strikeout. Howie Kendrick lined into a double play to end the first, and that was the break that Butler needed. He was all over the lot in the first inning, gave up the three-run home run, walked three men in the inning, but now he's just throwing strikes. But the big story for the Dodgers tonight, Julio Urias, allowed one run in four innings, made 86 pitches, and everybody knows what they have said about him is true. Signed at 16, pitching in the big leagues at 19. God willing, he stays healthy. He'll pitch for a long, long time. Well, the Giants are at home with the Red Sox, and the Giants were down 1-0, 2-1, but not now. Giants lead the Red Sox 3-2 in the fifth inning. And a sinker swung on and missed, picked up by Garneau, who tags down the line, and that'll be that for Kendricks. So, yes, Butler is very much at home. Urias looked very much at home, and he's going to stay at home. And at the end of four, Dodgers 3, Rockies 1. by your Southern California Toyota dealers. Toyota's Summer Drive Sales event is going on now, where you can save big on the all-new Prius. We go to the fifth inning with the Dodgers leading 3-1. For Julio Urias, he has to feel happy. He did a great job for four innings. His family is here. They made the trip. But he made a lot of pitches, 86 pitches. That's too much for that young arm. The Dodgers are not going to risk it. So his family will just sit back and relax. He didn't go the five innings required as a starter, so he can't win. But he did win over the crowd and has shown everybody the stuff they've always been talking about. So now it's Lewis Coleman. Lewis Coleman is suddenly walking out on the stage after Rex Harrison does not show up in the middle of My Fair Lady. And well, wait a minute. Where did Harrison go? That's a tough role for Lewis Coleman. 3-1 Dodgers, fifth inning. 1-1. Dustin Garneau, the catcher, struck out in the second inning. So what Urias did, he struck out seven in four innings. He allowed one run, three hits. He had one walk with the seven Ks. The only run occurred on the single by LeMahieu, stole second, and Arenado doubled high off the left field wall to score LeMahieu. How did that affect Urias? He turned right around and struck out Carlos Gonzalez a second time. So Arenado got him, but he gets everybody. Still 1-2. Again, in looking back about Urias, who is certainly a major part of the game, against the Mets, he only went 2 2/3 innings, and they say he was really overcome by the huge crowd, the lights in New York. No swing. So he went 2 2/3. Then in Chicago, he went five innings, but he gave up eight hits. Tonight, for whatever reason, very much at home, very confident. One run, three hits, struck out seven. But those foul balls, 19 of them, off the bats of the Rockies, took its toll. 3-2 the count to Garneau. The pitcher, Eddie Buttley, on deck. Dodgers three runs, four hits. Rockies one run, three hits. And that's off the plate. Ball four. See, friends, you can gear up for summer with a Dodger Cooler backpack. It's available to the first 40,000 fans in attendance June the 20th, courtesy of your SoCal Honda dealers. For tickets, visit Dodgers.com/promotions. Adrian Gonzalez over to the mound a moment to talk to Coleman. Butler looks like he might be a reasonable hitter. He grounded out in the third inning, and we'll see if they're looking bunt. He led off and grounded out in the third inning, showing bunt. Bunt's foul. 0-1. Rockies here tomorrow night, the concluding game of the series and of the homestand. Chris Rusin and Kenta Maeda. Then the Dodgers go to San Francisco. Kershaw and Cueto. Cueto's 9-1, believe it or not, for the Giants. That'll be quite a matchup. Then Scott Kazmir will go up against Jeff Samardzija. And Mike Bolsinger is due to go up against Jake Peavy. So the Giants will see Kershaw. The Dodgers will not see Bumgarner. 0-1. Got the bunt foul. 0-2. He does have one sacrifice. In fact, let me check that more. He has three sacrifices. Eddie's switch hitter. I wonder though if he's a switch hitter. The notes say he's a switch hitter. The sheet says he's a switch hitter. Why would he bat right-handed against Coleman unless he feels he can bunt better right-handed? Got it down. Good bunt. Randolph's throwing to second. Got him. Well, a nice play by Yasmani Grandal to nail Garneau. One catcher nailing the other. So Butler winds up bunting into a force play. Seager right there. No further play. So on the bunt, it's only a force, and we have one down. LeMahieu coming up. Good play by Yasmani. He was talking about his sore left wrist. He was hit by a foul ball way back when the Dodgers played in Toronto. That'd be the 6th, 7th, and 8th of May, and it's been bothering him all the time. Long drive into the gap in right center off the bat of LeMahieu. They will stop Butler at third. DJ goes into second with a stand-up double, and the tying runs are out there with one out.
Left fielder Ryan Rayburn.
So LeMahieu flied to center, singled, and now doubles. The pitcher Butler held at third. And here comes Rayburn, followed by Arenado. So Coleman finding it a very tough act to follow. Urias had stolen the hearts of the crowd, had shut down the Rockies for four, struck out seven. And now all of a sudden, not that he can lose a win because he only went four. And ball one. Ryan Rayburn. Ryan Neal Rayburn. Back 1-1. So Lewis Coleman picks up here in the fifth, walked the leadoff man. Butler, the pitcher, bunted into a force, but LeMahieu just doubled. So Rayburn, who has doubled and struck out on a 1-1 count. Down and dirty, two balls and one strike. People are forever misspelling Rayburn's name. You know why? Everybody spells it with a Y, and there is no Y. There goes my man Joyce taking a walk. Yeah, Rayburn is the way it is. No why. Ryan said wherever he goes. He said, I tell people they still spell it wrong. My coaches spell it wrong. And that gets away. The runners, however, hold. 3-1 the count. Rayburn has a lot of power. We might tell you this. It was quite a while ago, 5 years ago. He made a little history. He became the first player ever to hit a ball off Safeco's field's retractable roof. That would be what? At least 250 feet, I would think. 3-1. And a strike. First base open. 3-2 to Ryan. Walt Weiss quietly cheerleading. Well, I checked. They say the roof is 217 feet at its highest point. Three and two. And there's ball four. So now the bases are loaded. The audience is hollering for Rex Harrison. And with one out, here comes, of all people, Nolan Arenado. Arenado walked and doubled. Adam Libator down in the pen. He would be called in, I guess, to face Gonzalez. And Honeycutt going out trying to help Lewis Coleman. Utley came in trying to help out. One of the things that Colorado has, they have an outfield. Never mind Nolan Arenado, but they have an outfield that has knocked in 98 runs going into this game. Arenado drove in the run, so he's a third baseman, but 98 ribbies for the Rockies outfield. And with a double in the first inning, a double in the third, and a double in the fifth, they have 209 extra base hits. Nolan Arenado checking in. He has three previous grand slams. And he is troubled. Three home runs, 23 RBI. The last year, Arenado had a grand slam home run against Brett Anderson. So he has Butler at third, LeMahieu at second, Rayburn at first, one out, 3-1 Dodgers. Off the plate, ball one. One of the things that Arenado amazes you about, I mean, he has walked and doubled. There's a lot of power, but he makes contact. He's only struck out 25 times this year. One ball and no strikes. And a high pop fly. That's all it is. And it'll be Upley. The infield fly rule is called. Boy, did the Dodgers dodge a bullet there as Arenado pops it up. He was so frustrated he threw his bat high in the air, not quite high enough to hit the Safeco roof. So that'll be all. They'll bring Libator in with the bases loaded to face Carlos Gonzalez. So this one is still very much up for grabs. 3-1 Dodgers, but they're in trouble, and we'll be right back. And with the bases loaded, two down, and the Dodgers trying to hold on to a 3-1 lead. After four brilliant innings by Julio Urias, who allowed one run, three hits, walk one, and struck out seven. Coleman made 19 pitches, gave up two walks and a double. And here comes Carlos Gonzalez. In his great career, he's had four grand slams. Arizona, San Diego, Washington, and Arizona again. Casey Fien gets up in the Dodger bullpen because the pitcher spot comes up second in the bottom of the fifth. So Gonzalez, smarting, has struck out twice, each time against Urias. The cargo checking in. Butler at third, LeMahieu at second, Rayburn at first. And a strike. Lewis Coleman, deep in thought, obviously disappointed. 0-1. Fastball. And it seems like Cargo has had a no ball two strike count on him every time he's walked up to the plate. Meanwhile, Arenado furious, having popped up in the fifth inning. 0-2 to Gonzalez. Cargo has struck out 47 times. Time. In the inning, Garneau walked. Butler forced him trying to advance with a bunt. LeMahieu, however, double Butler to third. Rayburn walked to load him up, and Arenado popped up. And now it's up to Libertor to get Carlos Gonzalez. Ball one. The block, the roadblock in the middle of the Rockies lineup. Gonzalez has struck out twice, and Story has struck out twice. That's the numbers four and five batters. And waiting on deck, Trevor Story. One ball and two strikes. Butler at third, LeMahieu the tying run at second, Rayburn at first, two out. Check, swing, swing, says the third base umpire, Chad Fairchild. That means Cargo strikes out a third time. Tommy Runnels, Walt Weiss can't believe it, and the Rockies lead three. And at the end of four and a half, there's the check. And it is a bum check. It won't work anywhere. 3-1, Dodgers. the Dodgers were facing disaster, and Nolan Arenado on the left popped up, and Carlos Gonzalez on the right struck out. Meanwhile, Liberatore saving Coleman and giving him a good-natured shove. So it's still 3-1 Dodgers, bottom of the fifth inning, and Grandal a strike. Dodgers will go to the bench. Scott Van Slyke will come up and bat for Liberatore. So Scotty waiting. Grandal made that fine throw on the bunt. Down in the Dodger bullpen, Joe Blanton now begins to loosen up. And that runs the count to 2-2. Since that disastrous first inning, Butler has faced only three men in the second, three men in the third, three men in the fourth. 3-2. And throwing at 96. Fastball, line drive right into the glove of Nolan Arenado, who's at the shortstop position, one down. Scott Van Slyke will come up. So it's been Urias, Coleman, Liberatore, with Van Slyke now batting for Adams. Scotty coming off the DL, trying to catch up with the rest of the big leaguers. He played right field last night, grounded out, fouled out, and was hit by a pitch. That's on the corner, so he's in a hole 0-2. And down he goes. The out reported at first, and we have two out. Just thinking about Nolan Arenado coming up with the bases loaded and pop up. He would not do that against the Giants. Nolan Arenado already this year has 18 runs batted in against the Giants in 10 games. Last year, all he did against the Giants was to hit 10 home runs and drive in 24. So in his last 28 games against the Giants, he has 42 RBIs. Now check him with the Dodgers. 50 games, 7 home runs, 26 RBIs, and a .251 batting average. So he does better against San Francisco and the Dodgers, and that was really important tonight. Utley fouls it off, 0-1. Chase Walk scored on the home run by Turner and struck out. Two down, bottom of the fifth inning, 3-1 Dodgers. First four innings, however, were electric, with Julio Urias striking out 7 and allowing 1 run. The only problem for the young left-hander, he made 86 pitches and had to come out. Going back into the books, Julio Urias has 7 strikeouts, for the most by a Dodger teenager. Remember, he's 19. Ground ball. That'll be that. The story makes the play, a 1-2-3 inning, and at the end of 5, 3-1 Dodgers. June 7, 1941, the Yankees were in St. Louis playing the St. Louis Browns. Yes, Virginia, there was a team called the St. Louis Browns. DiMaggio had three hits that day, knocked in one, scored two, and that was a safe hit for him in 22 consecutive games. He continued that until July the 16th, where he had that famous 56-game hitting streak. Jolting Joe DiMaggio was on his way on this day in 41. Let's go back to this one. Joe Blanton wearing number 55. That'd be Joe D's number twice. Ball one to Trevor Story. Story had a very tough time against Julio Urias. He struck out twice. Urias struck out seven. I was starting to tell you that Urias' seven strikeouts were the most by a Dodger teenager since Don Drysdale was a teenager and struck out nine in Connie Mack Stadium back in 1956. And as he was 19 years old, he went the distance and won the game 6-1. Story, who has struck out twice, has a one ball, two strike count. Two balls, two strikes. So the Dodgers with Urias, Coleman, Liberatore, and Blanton. And the Rockies have now struck out nine times. Urias had seven. Liberatore got one. And now Blanton takes care of Story. So in the heart of the lineup, Gonzalez has struck out three times. Story has struck out three times. And here's Reynolds, who has grounded out and struck out. It's not the end of Story, however. It's only the sixth inning. That's a strike. The veteran Reynolds 0-2. One ball and one strike. Mark Reynolds at one time was really a strikeout machine. I mean, he had a lot of power, but it seemed like he was always striking out. With the Diamondbacks in 2008, he struck out 204 times. The next year with the Diamondbacks, he struck out 223 times. And the next year with the Diamondbacks, he struck out 211 times. And the next year, he was playing in Baltimore. 1-2. Slider, 2-2. Mark's mom is a teacher. His dad's in the automobile business. He was on an infield as a kid with Ryan Zimmerman. 2-2. 3-2. Mark Reynolds. 6'2", 220. 33 years old come August. Foul back. Of course, with that big free swing of his, he also hit as many as 28 home runs and 30 home runs. And fastball hit straight away left, coming up for it and trapping the ball is Howie Kendrick. So a one out single by Mark Reynolds, and that will bring up Gerardo Parra.
The fielder Gerardo Parra.
So you celebrate Dodger pitching great Don Newcomb's 90th birthday tomorrow. First 40,000 fans in attendance receive a Don Newcomb bobblehead presented by United Healthcare. For tickets, visit Dodgers.com/promotions. Big Nuke gets his bobblehead tomorrow. Well, here's Parra, grounded out and lined out to short, 0 for 2. And the strike. Gerardo Enrique Parra. In the dirt. One ball and one strike. One and two. Gerardo Parra is a collector. He collects his own gloves. He'll use one glove a person. He'll have a backup ready just in case. If he plays winter ball, he'll use the same glove. And then when winter ball is over, that's it for the glove. He's saying that the pitch was fouled in the dirt, but he's done. The Parra strikes out. It's 10 Rockies have struck out. 7 at the hands of Urias. Then you had 1 for Coleman, 1 for Libertor, and 2 now. So that'll make it 11. Here's Garneau. He struck out and walked. It's at that stage where you start looking, well, who didn't strike out? LeMahieu did not. And Arenado. Everybody else has bitten the dust. Finish the note on Parra. When the year's over, he takes the glove, and all of the gloves he has ever used are all in his living room. Maybe in a storage case, but they're all there, including the one that he used to win a gold glove. One ball and one strike. Two down, Reynolds at first, 3-1 Dodgers. Ground ball to short. Seager to Utley. No runs to hit a man left. And at the end of 5.5 innings, the Dodgers getting strong relief from Coleman, Libertor, and Blanton. They lead 3-1. brought to you by Nissan. Choose Nissan today for great offers on our most exciting lineup ever. Shop online at ChooseNissan.com. And by Carl's Jr., the California Classic Double Cheeseburger for just $2.49 at Carl's Jr. A picture from the past, Maury Will stealing third after stealing second against the Giants. Jimmy Davenport trying to grab the overthrow but went on down the line. And Wills picked himself up and scored. The Dodgers led at that point 4-2. And the Giants scored four in the top of the ninth. 1-6-4 eliminated the Dodgers and advanced to the 62 World Series. The winning pitcher of that game, Don Larsen of World Series no-hit fame. That was game number 165, the third game of the best of three National League playoff, 1962, the year that this beautiful ballpark was first built. Up north, Red Sox and Giants going round and round. They're tied 3-3 in the top of the seventh inning as Corey Seager takes ball four.
Third baseman, Justin Turner.
So Justin Turner coming up. Four walks given up by Eddie Butler, who was breezing after the sky fell on him, pushed down by Justin Turner's three-run home run in the first inning. Last time up, Turner hit into a force play. Ground ball hard to third. Arenado to LeMahieu, quickly to DP. Good, just like that, two down in the sixth inning. So Butler somehow has just turned into a completely different pitcher. He looked like somebody was just overwhelmed in the first inning, couldn't throw a strike, faced the first three batters, and it was 3-0. But after the first inning, he's done a tremendous job. He's allowed two hits and a walk since the first inning, and we have two out in the sixth. Gonzalez, a case in point, he singled in the first inning, hit into a double play in the third. Foul back. The double play in the third, when you write it down, it looks kind of strange, but it's all because of the shift. The ground ball went to LeMahieu, who is the second baseman, except LeMahieu is out in the outfield. So it was the shortstop Story playing second base. He got the ground ball and threw it to Arenado, the third baseman. One ball and one strike. Chad Qualls begins to loosen up in the Rockies bullpen. Just off the plate. Butler will lead off in the seventh, which means he'll probably go out for a hitter. And the veteran Qualls heating up. Foul back. 2-2 the count. So the Giants are tied up 3-3 with the Red Sox. Dodgers are leading 3-1. Dodgers for the moment are four games behind San Francisco. Ground ball to first. Reynolds takes it to the bag. That'll be that. Another very nice inning for Eddie Butler. In fact, after the first inning, believe it or not, Butler faced only three men in every other inning. But it's 3-1 Dodgers. Seventh inning, Dodgers trying to hold on to a 3-1 lead. Joe Blanton will pitch to the pinch hitter, Daniel Descalzo, the pride of San Carlos. He was with the Cardinals for quite a while, a third round pick out of UC Davis. Strike, 0-1. Descalzo, about 5'10", 190. Be 30 in October. That's a strike, 0-2. He was with the Cardinals five straight years and then came over to the Rockies. 0-2. Off the plate. Descalzo, born in San Carlos, so he grew up, his buddy was Brandon Crawford, who's now the Giants shortstop. They were teammates, not in baseball, but on the soccer field. And drives it down the right field line. If it's fair, it's going to go. And it is fair. Daniel Descalzo comes off the bench and hits a home run. Well, he had four home runs a couple of years ago. And Descalzo, from whom you don't expect a home run, and they get it. It was up and out. That was his first home run of the year. Eight runs batted in, and now it's a 3-2 game. DJ LeMahieu flied to center, single to left, stole a base and scored, and doubled in the fifth inning. So LeMahieu, 2-for-3. And Descalzo gets the Rockies close. 0-1. Rockies could kick themselves, I'm sure, when they had the bases loaded, one out, and came up empty when Arenado popped up and Gonzalez struck out. Pedro Baez begins to warm up in the Dodger bullpen. Arenado had walked and doubled and then popped her up. Ball one. DJ, we mentioned earlier, very tall for a second baseman. Going back to 1925 to find another second baseman that big. 1-2. 2-2. So it's been Urias, who was brilliant for four innings. One run, three hits, struck out seven. However, he made 86 pitches, and the Dodgers just did not want to risk injury to that very talented left arm. Then it's been Coleman, Liberatore, and Blanton. For Eddie Butler, he just completely turned things around. For all you know, it could be a turning point in Butler's career. You know, the Dodgers were knocking him from pillar to post. He was 0-4 lifetime against them. He had an earned run average of 7 against the Dodgers. But he pitched really well after the first inning. Justin Turner wrecked him for the moment anyway with a 3-run home run. 2-2 the count to David John LeMahieu out of Bloomfield Hills, Michigan. Strike three call. So that's one out. Take a look at what's ahead for the Dodgers. One more game tomorrow night. And then Thursday, they'll fly out of Los Angeles, go to San Francisco, and play the three-game series with the Giants. That'll be 7:15 Friday night, 4:15 Saturday, and 5:37 on Sunday. Then on to Arizona for three, and then home. Ball one. Ryan Rayburn has double, struck out, and walked. And that's going to go into right field for a base hit. The Rayburn, who doubled and walked, now comes up with a single, so he's having a good night going the other way. And now for the next chance to hurt the Dodgers, here comes Nolan Arenado. Arenado walked in the first inning, doubled to drive in LeMahieu in the third, and with the bases loaded and one out, popped it up, flipped his bat high in the air, and then Gonzalez followed by striking out for the third time. The Honeycutt on the phone. LeMahieu stole second against Urias in the third inning. Baez down in the pen. And a strike. Arenado can't believe it. Almost got hit by it. 297 with 18 home runs, 49 runs batted in. But he's smart. He's not saying anything to Joyce. One out. Seventh inning, 3-2 Dodgers. One ball and one strike. Dodgers got three in the first inning. Rockies came back with one in the third. Descalzo has just pinch hit a home run. And now LeMahieu, after striking out, Rayburn singles to be the tying run at first. One and two. Arenado and Trace Thompson are close pals. They played against each other, played with each other growing up. Now facing each other in the big leagues. Two and two. When the Dodgers come up, Thompson will lead off. Three runs, four hits for the Dodgers. Two runs, seven hits for Colorado. Fastball lifted to shallow center. Peterson coming in a hurry. And it is juggled and caught, and the throw to first is a wild throw into the Rockies dugout. That should be a good break. That will send the runner to second base. That was quite a play out there. A 3-0 of Dodgers. We're going to take another look just to show you with their backs to home plate. And on that throw, Rayburn goes all the way to third. Seager made a wonderful play over the shoulder for a moment there. The blind spot as he caught it, and he was going by Peterson. And then throwing the ball into the Colorado dugout. So Rayburn gets back to third. So the tying run now is 90 feet away. And Dave Roberts saying, just a minute. You have Carlos Gonzalez coming up. Kike Hernandez going to come in and take over in left field. And we'll see if they're going to bring in Baez. And it looks like they are. So Hernandez will be in left. Baez will be the pitcher. The tying run will be 90 feet away, and we'll be right back. Brought to you by BMW. See a Southern California BMW center today for exceptional offers or visit SoCalBMW.com. And by Children's Hospital Los Angeles. We treat kids better. Kike Hernandez comes into the ball game. Justin Turner will come out of the game because Howie Kendrick has taken over third base. So I assume that Baez would go into Turner's spot if you're keeping score. Then Hernandez would bat ninth. So Baez facing Carlos Gonzalez with the tying run at third. Gonzalez has struck out three times tonight, twice against Urias, once against Libertor. Ball one, almost a wild pitch. With a runner at third and somebody who throws as hard as Baez, that's always a problem. He has one wild pitch and one balk. One ball and no strikes. And one hopper knocked down but off the glove of Utley. No play. And the tying run scores. Though we'll wait on the score. Ball hit hard. Utley did have his glove on it and it exploded and spun away. So Blanton is charged with the run. It's going to go as a base hit for Gonzalez. And a run batted in. So after the great catch by shortstop Corey Seager, his throw really punishes the Dodgers. It winds up in the Rockies dugout. Tying run went to third and comes home on the base hit. So 3-3. This has been quite an inning with the pinch hitter Daniel Descalzo coming off the bench and hitting a rare home run. Ball one to Story. So for Eddie Butler, the world was coming to an end in the first inning. Now he's off the hook and could even win the game. Blanton charged with two runs here in the inning. One ball and no strikes. 2-0. Story struck out in the first, the fourth, the sixth. So the Rockies weren't going to go anywhere with six strikeouts between Gonzalez and Story. 2-0 the count. Three, three in the seventh. Whoa. Almost got him with a 98 mile an hour fastball. End of Story. Three and oh. Would they let him swing considering the fact he has 16 home runs? On a 3-0 pitch, we'll find out in a minute. Two out. Strike. Baez, as usual, throwing hard, 98. Three and one. Whoa. A 99 mile an hour fastball and Story not quite able to catch up to it. 3-2 to young Trevor. Rockies have eight hits for their three runs. So Baez comes in and strikes out Story. but the infield single scores the tying run. And we're heading for the bottom of the seventh inning in a 3-3 tie. You buy Cricket Wireless. Cricket, something to smile about. As we go to the bottom of the seventh inning, Charlie Blackman takes over in center field. Gerardo Parra moves over to left. So coming out of the game is Ryan Rayburn, and coming into the game is Jason Lewis Mott. He goes hand in hand along with Daniel Descalzo as former Cardinals. Jason Mott, born in Port Huron, Michigan, but lives in Johnson City, Tennessee. He'll be 34 in June, an even 6-200 pounder. Went to Iona College in New York. Slider for a strike. Trace Thompson. Foul ball. Thompson has walked and hit back to the box. For the Dodgers, remember Hernandez is batting ninth. Baez is in Turner's spot. And we are looking. Charlie Blackman will bat ninth for the Rockies. And the pitcher Mott will go in Rayburn's spot. That's going down the line, but it's also slicing foul. 0-2 the count. Three runs, four hits for the Dodgers. Three runs, eight hits for the Rockies. Mott was drafted by the Cardinals as a catcher out of Iona. Even as scouts asked him to pitch and teammates marveled at his arm. He was never tempted to get in front of a radar gun and see just how hard or fast he could throw. He was content catching. But on the scouting scale of 20 to 80, his arm was 80. Fastball, chopper to the middle man. Trevor Story. One away. Bottom of the seventh inning. Jock Peterson coming up.
Center fielder number 31. Jock Peterson.
Anyway, about Mott, they would check him as a catcher, and he was 1.7 seconds from glove to glove
meaning from catcher's mitt to the glove of the second baseman. He said it never meant much to him. I just threw. I enjoyed it. Well, eventually, after three seasons as a catcher, he only hit 188. And so that made the switch to the mound. Oh, and one to Jock. Peterson hit into a force play, struck out 0-4-2. Dodgers have four hits. The three hits, the three runs, all in the first inning. Seager has walked, infield single, walked again. Corey making that great over the catch, heading for center field, but then the throw that wound up in the Rockies dugout turns up to be the biggest play, allowing Rayburn to go to third, and Gonzalez single tied it up. 2-1 the count to Jock Peterson. Howie Kendrick on deck. Fastball pop foul, out of play. When the Rockies come up in the eighth inning, they'll have Mark Reynolds, Gerardo Parra, and then Charlie Blackmon after the catcher Garneau. Two and two. Fastball hit up the middle, but right behind second base is Story to throw him out. So Peterson, what looks like a base hit, he certainly hit it hard enough, but Story was perfectly positioned. Two down in the seventh, Howie Kendrick hit into a double play and struck out. Started the game in left field, finishing up the game at third base. Jason Mott made the change from catcher to pitcher in 2006. He was then pitching for Quad Cities, and by 2008 he was pitching in the big leagues. One ball and one strike to Howie. A couple of years ago, Jason Mott put his name on a foundation aiding cancer patients and the families in Memphis, where he and his family call home. Fouled away. Actually, the idea came from his wife. She was driving home from St. Louis to Memphis. His wife was going to coach at a youth basketball camp. And anyway, they wound up assisting the Wings Cancer Foundation. Two and two. Little chopper. Fair ball, fair ball. Out. So 1-3. Nice inning for Jason Mott. And at the end of seven in a tough ball game, we have a 3-3 tie. inning of a 3-3 tie. The biggest play of the night was not the pinch hit home run by Descalzo, nor was it the double by Arenado to score LeMahieu. It was a combination play. That was in the seventh inning with one out, a runner at first. Arenado hit a pop fly into shallow center. Peterson was coming hard. Seager was coming hard. And as they went by each other, somehow Seager caught the ball over his shoulder. Turned, thinking maybe he could get Rayburn. Instead, he threw the ball into the Colorado dugout. That sent Rayburn all the way to third. And Carlos Gonzalez singled off the glove of Chase Utley, and the tying run came home. So we're 3-3 in the eighth. Here's Reynolds. Right. Mark grounded out, struck out, single a left. Reynolds with three home runs, 17 runs batted in, but he has always had power. Foul back. 0-2. Dodgers scored three in the first inning and have not been heard from. I mean, remember last night they had one hit for one run. Tonight, since the first inning, they've had two hits. Just off the plate at 98. Urias, Coleman, Libertor, Blanton, Baez. Slider at 88. The paid attendance tonight. Nice crowd, 40,525. 4-0. 5-2-5. Boy, that was some fastball. That was moving at 99. It was moving away. Reynolds pretty fortunate to get a piece of that one. Two and two. Just did get a little bit of that. I guess you can't really get off a good swing when somebody's throwing 99. Of course, Mark's been around facing so many pitchers over the years. He's seen just about every pitch and every velocity. 2-2. And he dropped all the way down with a slider to 87. So down goes Reynolds. Follow Dodger Baseball Live with the MLB.com at bat app. Stay up to the moment at any moment with game day live game video highlights, StatCast, news, and more. Download MLB.com at bat, the number one app for live baseball on your phone and tablet. Well, Baez picks up his second strikeout. Little roller Dudley. So Gerardo Parra goes 0-for-4. Two out in the eighth. Dustin Garneau, the catcher, coming up.
Catcher number 13.
For the Rockies tonight, their biggest problem was making contact. As a team, they have struck out 13 times. Urias had 7. Coleman 1, Libertor 1, Blanton 2, Baez 2, Arenado has avoided striking out. Carlos has struck out three times. So did Story. In fact, check me on Story. He struck out four times. And an off-speed pitch for a strike. Off-speed at 86. Of course, when a guy's thrown 98, 99, what else do you call it? Fastball, and it's going to be hit into center. A 97 mile an hour base hit, and that will bring up Charlie Blackmon. This will be Blackmon's first at bat.
Center fielder number 19, Charlie Blackmon.
Charlie hitting 301, six home runs, 27 runs batted in, has reached base 32 straight games. He had a single and a walk last night. It's going to be tough for him to keep that streak alive now because he's had only this chance for it. They're in the bottom of the ninth up north. Red Sox 3, Giants 3. Dodgers trail by 4 and the Rockies trail by 8. Fastball missed. So for Baez, he allowed the home run and two other singles in the seventh inning, and now a base hit here in the eighth. One and one. Charlie, a very good all-around ball player, has great speed. He has stolen four bases, covers a lot of ground in center field or right, especially center. One and one. Popped in the air, foul, out of play. So Baez not only throwing hard, he's throwing strikes. However, he came in the seventh inning, gave up that home run to pinch hitter Daniel Descalzo with one out. Rayburn singled. Then Arenado hit the pop fly. Seager made a great catch, overthrew first, put the tying run at third, and Gonzalez singled off Utley's glove to tie it up. Fastball. Good spot, not just the velocity. Blackmon, just like the previous hitter, Mark Reynolds, just did get a pitch of it. It was out of the zone, but he was still able to nail it. One and two. Waiting on deck, DJ LeMahieu, who has a single, a double, and a stolen base, scored a run. Two and two. Dodgers will have Grandal leading off in the eighth. Three and two. Three and two down, so Garneau will be going, Blackmon waiting, and LeMahieu on deck. 3-3 tie, two out in the eighth. Time. on Blackman. The outfield is deep, almost straight away. Peterson slightly over a little toward left center, but not much. Runner goes, and down goes Blackman. So that's four strikeouts for Baez. A runner left at first. Yes, you're seeing quite a game. And as long as Dad is there, the world is fine. 3-3. Rockies go into the bottom of the eighth inning. The big right-hander, German Herman, whom we saw last night, he pitched the ninth inning and set the Dodgers down in order. So Gonzalez, whose last name, although starting with a G, is pronounced with an H. Herman, ready to pitch to Hasmany Grandal. Then it would be Kike Hernandez and Chase Utley. All one. Grandal tonight, single to right, lined out. And that gets away ball two. In the Dodger bullpen, Kenley Jansen. Herman out there on the mound is 6'2", 195. Be 29 in September from La Romana in the Dominican Republic. Right-handed all the way and was originally signed by the Mets 9 years ago. Picked up by the Cubs and claimed by the Rockies off the Cub. High fly playable ball to Charlie Blackman. So one away. Again, to show you how things change dramatically, the Dodgers scored three runs on a three-run home run and a single. They got a base hit in the second inning. They had a base hit in the third inning, and the offense has not been heard from since. Since the infield single by Seager in the third inning, the Dodgers have gotten one man on base, and that was a walk to Seager in the sixth inning. So the offense started off okay, but it is now retired to where it was last night when they had one hit. 0-1 to Kike Hernandez. Pop fly, a trio. It's the middleman LeMahieu. Two out in the eighth. up north, they're going to the 10th inning.
Second
the Red Sox 3 and the Giants. Dodgers will have Chase Utley coming up now. When the Rockies come up in the ninth, they'll have LeMahieu to start it off, then the pitcher spot, and then Nolan Arenado and Carlos Gonzalez. And a strike. Arenado all alone on the left side. One ball and one strike. Utley 0 for 2, did walk in the first inning. Just off the corner. 2-1. Dodgers began the night 4 games behind the Giants. Two and two. The book on Herman. Good two seam fastball, change up, slider. Two and two. Fastball. Two out, eighth inning, and a 3-3 tie, and a crowd of 40,000 seeing a dandy tonight. 11 every minute. Fastball outside. Boy, that was close. I think Herman thinks that was a strike, but the catcher didn't say anything.
Corey Seager.
All right, Utley at first. Walt Weiss coming out and talking to the plate umpire. That might mean a double switch. We haven't seen anybody come out of the Rockies dugout yet. Boone Logan, a left-hander, is down in the bullpen. They might bring him in to face Corey Seager. And he's waiting for the call. Weiss is going to the mound, so let's see. You're going to consume a little time. It looks like he was ready. Yeah, there goes Herman. Okay, we'll be right back. in the bullpen, and he came running in with Logan to get into the game. So if you're keeping score, put Hundley in the number two slot. That means he'll bat second in the inning. And you can put Logan in the starting catcher's job. That would be number eight, Garneau. So Boone Logan, just recently called up, is dropped in to face, of all people, Corey Seager. Corey tonight walked, single, walked again. Yeah, Buckley at first with two out. Pretty consistent, 288 and 281. Boone Logan is out of San Antonio, still lives in Texas. For a strike. He's big, he's 6 feet five, 220 pounds. He'll be 32 in August. Originally signed by the White Sox. And you have Utley at first with two out, a tiebreaker. Fastball, check, swing. So the count 0-2 to Corey Seager. Boone Logan first came up to the big leagues in 2007. He's been with quite a few teams, White Sox and the Braves. Spent a lot of years with the Yankees. And he's been with the Rockies three different times. Off speed, strike three called on that slow curveball. Corey doesn't think so, but down he goes. So we have eight innings in the books in a 3-3 tie. Three tie. You don't normally see Jansen pitching in a tie, and certainly not when the Dodgers are behind. Normally he comes in to protect the lead and turn the lights out, but right now he's asked to keep the lights on and let the Dodgers come up in the bottom of the ninth. The pitchers have done a lot of work tonight. Jason Mott made 15 pitches. Joe Blandon made 36. Baez made 25. Herman made a dozen. Logan came in and made three pitches to strike out Seager. So DJ LeMahieu, then the catcher Hundley, and the third baseman Arenado against Jansen. Oh, well, let's take a look and see how the Rockies have done individually against Kenley Jansen. First of all, LeMahieu. LeMahieu 1-for-6 in the pass. Arenado is 1-for-5. And a strike. LeMahieu flied to center deep in the first inning. single to left, stole second, scored on Arenado's double in the third. Then he doubled to right in the fifth, and last time up struck out in the dirt. Fifth inning is when the Rockies could kick themselves. They had the bases loaded with one out, and Arenado and Gonzalez coming up, the best that Walt Weiss had. And Arenado popped up, and Gonzalez struck out. But they scrambled in the seventh to tie it up. Fouled away. DJ LeMahieu at 6'4", as big a second baseman as you'll ever see. And a good one, gold glove. Just off the plate. Two balls, two strikes. LeMahieu, born in Visalia, then moved to Las Vegas and eventually Bloomfield Hills in Michigan. Foul ball. Kenley Jansen. Dodgers give him the ball and hope. His record is 1-1. His earned run average is 1.2. And he has that remarkable combination of walks and strikeouts. In the dirt. Jansen has allowed one home run. Nick Hundley is on deck, and then Nolan Arenado. Three and two. And a ball four. So LeMahieu, who has a stolen base, opens up with a walk.
Catcher number four, Nick Hundley.
Nick Hundley coming up. Hundley is hitting 276. He has two home runs, eight runs batted in. Garneau did the catching tonight. Nolan Arenado hitting behind him, and then Carlos Gonzalez. Hundley is 0 for 6 against Jansen. LeMahieu has stolen 6 bases. Looks like Hundley's going to try to bunt. Got it down. Jansen's only play is to Hundley. So the sacrifice works. And now you have Arenado and Gonzalez back to back. So Hundley does his job. Little meeting at the mound as to what they're going to do with Arenado. Nolan walked, doubled high off the left field wall to drive in LeMahieu with his double, but then popped up with the bases loaded. Last time up was the most important play of the night when he hit that pop fly into shallow center. A trio of Dodgers, Seager, Peterson, Utley, and Seager and Peterson looked like they might almost collide. For one split second, you lost the ball, and it turned out that Seager had caught it going away over his shoulder. Then he whirled and threw to first, trying to double up Rayburn, and the throw went into the Rockies' dugout. That sent Rayburn to third, and he scored on a base hit off Huntley's glove, Utley's glove, and that tied it up. All right, Hundley gets the bunt down. Here's Arenado. One out. Ball one. Arenado going head to head with Kenley Jansen. Nolan, one hit, five at bats. LeMahieu hounded by Utley, who was standing on the bag for a moment. High pop fly. Back a third down the line. Seager. So Arenado pops up for the second time, this time to Seager. And the batter will be Carlos Gonzalez.
Right fielder number five, Carlos Gonzalez.
Carlos Gonzalez struck out three times in the first, in the third, in the fifth, and then hit that hard single off Chase Utley's glove in the seventh inning, and the tying run scored. 3-3. Two out in the ninth. Xander Bogaerts just had a two-run single in the 10th inning, and the Red Sox are leading the Giants 5-3. That was against Garcia. And a strike. Carlos Gonzalez is 3-for-11 with a double in the past against Kenley Jansen. Two out, ninth inning, 3-3. LeMahieu, pretty good lead. Seager trying to bird dog him out there. When Carlos Gonzalez came into the game, he had 45 strikeouts. Now he has 49, and he's in a hole, no balls and two strikes. LeMahieu, a tiebreaker, waiting out there with two down. Ball one. Pretty good 95 mile an hour fastball. When the Dodgers come up in the bottom of the ninth inning, the way their lineup has been scrambled, the pitcher's spot has been in the number three slot. So it will be Jansen or a pinch hitter in the bottom of the ninth. One ball and two strikes. $40,525 taken in the ball game tonight, and it is at a pivotal point. One and two. Two and two. Three runs, nine hits for the Rockies. Three runs, four hits for the Dodgers. Two and two. And now Kenley wants to talk to Grandal. So in the inning, LeMahieu walked. Hundley got him to second base with a bunt. Arenado popped up. And Gonzalez with a two and two count. Trevor Story, right hand batter on deck. He's had a really rough night. Story has struck out four times. Two and two. It might have been off the plate, but Carlos could not afford to take it. So that was a protected swing. See how far it was. Yeah, out there. It was definitely out of the strike zone. Still 2-2. If you take Gonzalez, Story, and Reynolds, you have 9 strikeouts amongst them. Make it 10. So Gonzalez strikes out 4 times. Story struck out 4 times. Reynolds struck out 2, and that's the heart of the lineup. And we have a 3-3 tie. Tonight they have 9 hits. They've left 10 men on base. They had a bases loaded one out in the 5th inning and failed to score. So the Dodgers now trying to make a move and win it here in the bottom of the 9th inning. Austin Barnes will bat for Kenley Jansen. Jansen made 16 pitches. Meanwhile, Boone Logan, who came in the 4th pitcher for the Rockies, and he'll face Austin Barnes, Adrian Gonzalez, and Trace Thompson. And if anybody gets on, Jock Peterson. So Logan, who came in and pitched to Seager and struck him out with a lot of slow curveballs. We'll see now how he handles Austin Barnes. Ball one. Logan basically fastball slider. There's the fastball at 93. He used to pitch directly over the top, and then the last year or two, he's dropped the arm a bit to 3/4, and he seems to have paid off. Fastball. Walt Weiss, talking about Logan, said, "We signed him. We were looking for another left-hander to pitch late in the game, and he's been huge for us." Logan, at the start of this year, 26-18 over his career. That's a strike. Two balls, two strikes. And ball three. Waiting on deck, Adrian Gonzalez. Boone Logan is a rancher in Texas. He has a ranch down near Laredo. As he said, I'm no Chipper Jones. My place is only 500 acres. Well, that's typical talk in Texas, isn't it? Off speed, fly ball to right field, Gonzalez. The Barnes fly ball to right, one down. Carlos Gonzalez coming up down in the Dodger bullpen.
ACC
is loosening up. Adrian single a left, hit into a double play and grounded out. Just to follow up on that ranch, the ranch has a name. It's called the Rio Seco Ranch, which means dry river in Spanish. I don't know if there are any dry rivers in Texas now. Oh. All right, one out, ninth inning, 3-3 tie. 0-1. Butler started the ball game after a very shaky first inning. He pitched exceptionally well through six. Then it was Mott. Then it was Herman, and now Logan. The Dodgers, Urias, who was brilliant for four, struck out seven. And then Coleman, Libertor, Blanton, Baez, Jansen. One ball and one strike. Fastball missed, 2-1. Adrian, 5 home runs, 28 runs batted in. Two and one. Ground ball to the middle man. Easy play for LeMahieu. So two down in the ninth inning. Trace Thompson coming up. Last night, the Dodgers had one hit. Tonight, they had a couple of hits in the first inning, and they have had two singles since. A single in the second inning and a single in the third. And now with two out and Thompson coming up, Walt Weiss goes to the pen, and we'll be back. Dominican Republic, 6-4 and 2-10. Young man at 24. Been with the Rockies since 2011. Trace Thompson is coming up, and of course the Dodgers look to him and think back to May the 10th against the New York Mets when he hit one out to turn the lights out. A walk-off home run to give the Dodgers the victory. Well, here he is, bottom of the ninth, 3-3 tonight. And Trace going up against Carlos Estevez. Thompson has 9 home runs, 21 runs batted in. Facing the 5th Colorado pitcher, the Dodgers have used 6 and a strike, 0-1. Basically from Estevez, fastball, curveball, and changeup. He can throw hard up to, they say, 99. And a fastball is whacked to left. And this one is gone. He has done it again. The Trace Thompson will hit the walk-off on May the 10th. Hits a walk-off tonight. And the Dodgers, after 3 runs in the first inning, are finally heard from again as Trace hits his 10th. So the total, the Dodgers 4 runs, 5 hits, 1 error. The Rockies 3 runs, 9 hits, and no errors. The Giants, I believe, lost. If so, the Giants did lose 5-3. So the Dodgers now trail the Giants by 3 games. Play of the game? Well, what kind of a memory do you have? Remember? Yeah, sure. So Thompson hits it out. The Dodgers have 2 home runs tonight to give them 63. And the Dodgers take the second game of the series 4-3. After the Rockies won last night 6-1. Kenta Maeda tomorrow night trying to win the rubber game. And then the Dodgers head on to San Francisco. We'll talk to you tomorrow. Look forward to that. Till then, we wish you all a very pleasant good evening, everybody.